Like you, we also defined our problem definition, design challenge, and list of requirements last week. So now it's time for some creative problem solving.
In this video, we show you how we use the method to generate ideas.
First, prepare your workspace. Make sure you have enough drawing materials.
So today we apply the techniques analogies for idea generation and the scamper method. These are just tools as examples you can use, but a little extra inspiration can do no harm.
While browsing for sources, keep your design challenge at hand.
So I will explain one of the analogies we use in our idea generation, which is climbing the Eiffel Tower. In both scenarios, there's a conflict. On the one side, our user wants to have a healthy start of the day, but he feels responsible and wants to have an efficient morning. On the other side, we have this person who wants to climb the Eiffel Tower because he wants to see the view of Paris, but he has a fear of heights. So in both scenarios, there's a conflict, and you can think about solutions that this person would make in order to get them to the top of the Eiffel Tower. So for example, you could think of somebody guiding him through all the steps, or somebody pushing him in the elevator because the elevator will go up anyways. And this can give fruitful insights for solutions which you can project on the problem of your user.
Analogies will also help you to see the problem from different perspectives. Generate as many ideas as you can. If you think you collected enough, choose some so you can apply the scamper method.
So I think it's time to go further into scamper.
Yeah.
With these ideas.
I've used it before, and I made these little cards.
Oh.
To make it a bit more fun to ask all the scamper questions and split it up.
Oh, that's a great idea.
Yeah.
If you came up with a satisfying number of ideas, it is time to cluster them. We made pictures of the full pages before cutting them into pieces, because you might want to look back to see how you imagined things in the first place. When you cluster ideas, it is easy to have them all on separate pieces of paper. Clustering ideas and choosing between them will make you solve the problem in different directions. In that way, you won't have similar outcomes in the concept phase.
So now let's choose a number 1, 2 and 3.
Well, that was inspiring.
Yeah, let's see how an expert applies this method in practice.